In this video, we are going to discuss about the different categories which we can define in order to start the circulation. Before we discuss about the circulation, it is very important to discuss what are the things required for starting the circulation. In any good library, when you think of starting the circulation, you need two things, and without these you cannot start the circulation, and those are: the detail of books should be there in your library. I mean, if you are using software, the detail of books should be there in the software also. And the other one, that the user detail, we call it as a patron. So the detail of the patron also should be there in the library or software. When these two are available, we can start the circulation easily, because if the user is available and the document is available, we can issue the document, and at the same time we can return the document also. So in this video we are going to discuss that, the patron first. Now the question is here, what type of patron may be in your library? It depends on the different libraries. For an example, if it is a university library, you may be having many subject or courses where you may be having the UG, PG, PhD, faculty, visiting faculty. If you are taking the school library, you may be having the users, staff. Likewise, it depends on the different kind of user available in your institute or organization. So based on that, we define the category. And for that, the category definition is completely depends on the privilege. If you are giving the privilege to all the users, same privilege, then I think there is no need to create many categories, because all the users are going to have the same privilege. It will reduce your workload, and also it will help you to manage the software. But in case where the users are of different kinds and also having the different privilege, for an example, the UG students are getting 4 books for 30 days, PG students are getting 6 books for 30 days, and likewise faculty different set of books for different days. In that case, you have to define each category individually. So in Koha, how we can define the category? Let us see. First, you have to start with the staff admin phase, Koha staff interface, and there you have to log in with the username and password, admin username and password, and then you go to Koha administration. Here, as we define the basic parameter for starting the Koha, the same way we have to define the patron and circulation rule and regulation in order to start the circulation smoothly. So the first one we have to define is that patron categories. So you have to click on this option and it will open another window where you have to define the category. You can notice here there are already 4 categories defined in this Koha, and to add another category you have to click on new category, which will open another window where you are supposed to fill all the details, required details, and then save it. So it will get saved here, and you can later define the rule and regulation. We'll come to that part later. First we have to define the category. Now you can observe another form is open, and you have to fill it completely. So let me take one example. I am going to create one category with the code WP, means works of participants. So I'll fill up all the details here, works of participants. The fields which are given in the red color here are compulsory, and you cannot skip all the fields in red color. The period of enrollment you can give in two way, first one in month, and the second one if you want to specify any particular date. So I assume that works of participants are going to be here for till 30th June. So I can choose the 30th June. So this category users will be able to access the library services, especially the circulation, till 30th of June 2017. Then age required. This is not compulsory in all the cases, especially in a school library, it can be implemented effectively. This is the enrollment fee. Generally, when we collect the enrollment fee from the users to be the member of library, we can give the member fee here or enrollment fee here. Overdue notice, if you are creating the category and want to send the overdue notices to these users of this category, so you have to select the overdue notice, yes. And then coming to the hold fee. Hold fee means reservation fee. If any user of this category creates the reservation or fills the reservation that okay, I want this book if it is issued, so for that he or she has to pay the fine. So in that case, you have to enter the hold fee here, reservation fee. So whenever he is placing the reservation, he will be charged this much amount. And then category type. What is the type of category? This is professional. Here the branch information. If you do not change it, it will go to all. It will be applicable to all the libraries. Or if you want to restrict this category to this particular library, so only this particular library will be using this category. And then below this, there is one option, default messaging preferences for this patron category. These are five items which will allow you to send the mail for different purposes. If you want to send the mail for item due, if you want to send the mail for advance notice, if any user has taken any book and you want to send and inform them that you have to return the book, so in 2 days advance the email will go. If any user fills the reservation, then he or she will get the mail. The same way, issue return also will be notified by the email. So when you finish all the detail, you have to save it. You can notice here the WP workshop participants category is created with all the options which you filled properly. So in this way we can create the patron category. In next video we are going to see that how we can set the circulation and fine rule for this category.